Hey guys, it's Pastor Anthony here with your Daily Excellence, coming to you once again with some very unusual news. And this is kind of the news that we've been talking about, or at least BP Earthwatch and Mike from Around the World and Paul Bagley have been talking about over the course of the last several weeks, with the northward shift of the equatorial convergence zone. And now we see CNN, of all places, has jumped on the bandwagon and is talking about how the weather patterns are shifting northward. The article here from CNN.com says this: an unusual shift in the weather has turned the Sahara green. And so, of course, they give you guys a little picture there showing that some of the Sahara is turning green. And it says, CNN says, there isn't much green in the Sahara Desert, but after an unusual influx of rain, the color can be seen from space creeping into parts of one of the driest places in the world. Satellite recently captured a plant life blooming in parts of the typically arid southern Sahara after storms moved there when they shouldn't. It has also caused catastrophic flooding, and scientists say a world warming due to fossil fuels pollution is making both more likely. Of course, they're going to put their spin on this, as you can tell, but we're just going to read it as it states, and then I'll give you my analysis here in just a moment. Rainfall in the north of the equator in Africa typically increases from July through September as the West African monsoons kicks into gear. The phenomenon is marked by an increase in stormy weather that erupts when moist tropical air near the equator meets hot and dry air from the northern portion of the continent. The focus of this stormy weather, known as the intertropical convergence zone, shifts north of the equator in the northern hemisphere's summer hots. Much of it sags south of the equator during the southern hemisphere warm months. But since at least mid-July, this zone has shifted further north than it typically should, sending storms into southern Sahara, including parts of Nigeria, Chad, Sudan, and even as far north as Libya, according to data from NOAA's Climate Prediction Center. As a result, these portions of the Sahara Desert are anywhere from twice as wet to more than six times wetter than they should be. All right, let's see. Let me fix that. There we go. These two potential causes for this strange shift north, according to Karstein, I'm not going to try and pronounce that last name, a climate researcher from the university in Germany. The translation from El Nino to La Nina has influenced how far north the zone has moved this summer. El Nino, natural climate pattern marked by warmer than average ocean temperatures in the equatorial Pacific, typically leads to a drier than normal conditions in the wet portions of West and Central Africa. La Nina, or even a bubbling one, can cause the same effect. A warming world is a significant factor. Okay, this is according to these people here at CNN. All right. The intertropical convergence zone, which is the reason for Africa's greening, moves further north, the warmer the world gets, is what this researcher from Germany says. At least this is what most models suggest. And so there's a picture here. It says the northward displacement of the ITZZ this fall is evident in a one-year-over-year comparison of vegetation greenness over Africa. So they're showing you here. Okay, they're admitting that this has been going on for over a year, guys. All right, that's what they're telling you. They're showing you that for the last year, we've been seeing this upward movement. That's what they just said right here. That's what this article is telling you guys, all right? So keep that in mind. Let's see. It says, a study published in the Natural Journal this June found further northward shifts of this zone could happen more frequently in the next couple of decades as carbon monoxide, a byproduct of fossil fuel pollution, levels increase as the world warms. That's according to them. Okay, we know what's really going on, guys. It's because the Earth is tilting. Okay, Mike told us about it. BP Earthwatch has been talking about. Paul Bagley's been talking about. Everybody's been talking about this up until just a few days ago, it was only France 24 that was putting this article. And now CNN is putting their own, in my personal opinion, okay, my personal opinion, is putting their own twist on this for their explanation. They're stating that it's because the world is warming, why this thing is moving northward. France 24, they're saying, hey, this thing's actually shifting. And we know, you know, according to what we've researched and according to what we know from what the Bible tells us, with the earth rocking to and fro, that the equator has shifted north, or the earth is tilting further south, causing these things to shift northward. And like I explained to you guys in the video I did, expect this shift to either continue tilting southward, or the earth may start tilting northward, and we may see this line shift way further south, okay? Like I said, this thing can swing back and forth like a pendulum on a clock. So just keep that in mind. All right, so the shift isn't just turning deserts green, but it's also disrupted the Atlantic hurricane season and had major consequences over the past few months for several African countries. Countries that should be getting more rainfall are getting less as storms shift northward. Parts of Nigeria and the Cameroon typically get drenched with at least 20 to 30 inches of rain from July to September, but have received only 50 to 80% of their typical rain since mid-July, which when you have a shift like that, that would typically, you would start seeing shifts in the weather patterns in other places. So that, I agree with that. Further north, typically drier areas, including parts of Nigeria, or Niger, Chad, Sudan, and Liberia, and the southern Egypt have received more than 400 times their typical rainfall since mid-July, 400% more. And so you can kind of see the graph there, the red being the less amount of rainfall, the reds and oranges, yellows, and then you get into the greens and blues, that's the excessive rainfall rates, right? So it says here the blue areas were 400 to 600%. Of typical rainfall has fallen. Look at that. That's like the whole Sahara Desert, guys, receiving 400 to 600% more rainfall than they should. Take the northern part of Chad, which is part of the Sahara Desert, where only up to an inch of rain typically falls here from about mid-July to early September, but anywhere from 3 to 8 inches has already fallen in the same time frame this year. This excessive rainfall caused devastating flooding. In Chad, nearly 1.5 million people have been impacted, and at least 340 have been killed by the flooding in the country this summer, according to the United Nations briefing. Horrific flooding has also killed more than 220 people and displaced hundreds and thousands in Nigeria, mainly in the typically drier northern portion of the country, according to CNN. And of course, you can see some of the aerial flooding that they have been, has been going on. And what they're dealing with. So, yeah, it's pretty interesting, guys, to see what's happening, with Africa, and to see that, it's getting green. It's the Sahara Desert is turning green, guys. So maybe that's why, you know, I think people knew, that people knew that this transition was coming. That's probably why a lot of nations have been buying a lot of land in this area as of late, because it's about to turn to farmable land and resources, isn't it? So anyway, this is just more proof in the pudding of what everyone's been talking about. I just want to bring this forth. Like I said, coming from an unusual source, I think this is probably the first time I've ever shared an article from CNN, guys. So, well, weirder things happen, don't they? So anyway, that's all I have for you, just an update on this. But here we go, more proof, guys. Not just France 24 anymore, but now CNN doing an article about how the interconvergence zone has shifted northward. Of course, their article is stating that it's due to global warming. France 24 is actually stating that the Earth is tilted. We know that's due to the tilt and not so much due to global warming, in my personal opinion. All right? That being said, everyone, hey, thanks for watching, and we will see you guys in the next update. Bye, everyone. Wow.